Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Happy Friday, Tigers. I'm Jonathan Sosa.
And I'm Noah Smith. We'll be your anchors for this week's episode of Tiger Tube.
Hey, Noah, did you know that April is Autism Acceptance Month?
Of course. Let's go to Julia with more on the topic.
In 1970, the Autism Society launched an effort to make the month of April Autism Awareness Month, a month dedicated to promote the awareness of the condition and encourage all those affected by it. In 1972, the movement evolved into Autism Acceptance Month instead.
What I think about it was that I only found out, I didn't really know about it until 2021 of my eighth grade year during my karate lesson when my grandma was talking to my sensei about it.
The term autism refers to a wide spectrum of different behaviors and challenges that those diagnosed with it experience. Many who are diagnosed with the disorder struggle with sensory and communication challenges and medical illnesses because of the way in which autism impacts the nervous system.
At first I was confused, and then I started to look back, and I started to notice things in my life that I noticed that I did have it. And then I was like starting to put together the pieces onto what it was. I started to think that usually it's doesn't really matter what you have or what your disability is. I think of it as like an ability, but it's just who you are and what you decide to do with your life, and that's what's the most important to me.
There's no cure for this disorder. However, creating a welcoming and understanding environment for those who have autism can make all the difference.
Hey, do you know the IB counselor, Mr. Stanley?
Yeah, I heard he's retiring. Let's go to an interview to learn more about him.
Hi, Tigers. I'm here with Mr. Stanley to ask a few questions about counseling and the IB program.
First, could you tell us a little bit about your history and education and how you became a counselor here at Valencia?
I grew up in a family with teachers. My father was an educator. Early in my professional career, I met and married a teacher. I had been working in camping. I was a camp director over in Catalina Island. Realized my spouse, my wife's occupation as a teacher had a lot of benefits. I was young, and so I transitioned into teaching thereafter. That was 36 years ago.
Earlier this year, the Orange County Department of Education recognized you with the 2021 to 2022 K-12 Orange County School Counselor Award. What does this mean to you?
It was fun to get. I appreciate the accolades and the affirmation from my peers here at Valencia and my bosses at the district office and the school office. I love counseling. This is a great school to be a counselor at, and glad for the award, humbled by it, but really like what I do day to day, like the job much more than any accolades that I've gotten from it. So
you're the counselor for all IB and IB Valtech dual diploma students here. What real value does an IB or Valtech diploma achieve for students?
In terms of the development of the student, I think the IB Tech program really provides everything a parent, a family would want in terms of the development of the student. It's a broad kind of holistic liberal arts program, so it develops all aspects of the student. And we've really seen that in terms of the results with college admissions. So one of the first things colleges ask is, have you taken advantage of educational opportunities? And joining an academy program, IB, Valtech, and now Cambridge or Avid, allows you to answer that question in the affirmative, and again, it really translates to evidence of a student going above and beyond. in terms of the normal high school student.
You mentioned the Cambridge program. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
So the Cambridge diploma, again, like the IB diploma, is an international program. It's a pre-college diploma recognized throughout the world. When you apply to college, let's say in the United Kingdom, Canada, Asia, the colleges will know what you're talking about. They'll know your curriculum. It's a little less demanding than International Baccalaureate. It's a little more flexible than International Baccalaureate. So we really think it'll fit a real nice spot in terms of our curriculum in between IB and Tech or Avid. So we're hoping to have maybe 60, 70 students eventually doing the program every year. And again, we think it'll fit very well with what we're already doing with IB, Tech, and Avid.
So I have so many questions and I don't know where to start in answering them.
Well, Noah, I know the perfect person for you. Let's go to Read and Response to ask some questions.
So, welcome to Read and Responses. Crew ask me questions, I answer in this little box. Okay, first question.
I kind of hated that guy.
Me too.
Me three.
Me four. Me five.
Me six.
Come on. Okay, look. Come on. Let's just get this segment.
Let's just get on with the episode.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay. What is your favorite color? Well, it's blue.
Of course it's blue.
What are you doing here? Get out!
No!
Question two. What is your favorite part about this class? Well, I think my favorite part about this class, personally, I really like doing Rate and Response and just doing lots of creative things in this class. In fact, I think I see a couple of students right now just messing around, but that's besides the point. I think Video Production 1 is a pretty fun class, yeah. So question two, who is your favorite student?
Thoughts on Morbius?
Morbius is a painfully average movie. I hate it so much. The plot is predictable. The characters
are
predictable. What? I don't want you to do. I'm so tired of you insulting me, young man. I want you.
We work for sub-minimum wage.
What?
And you're talking to me about
don't like it at all!
And we don't like you! We don't like you!
No! I don't like you!
I like your mom more than I like you. She's a nice lady.
My mom is mid.
So why are you wearing a tiger head? It's too much.
I needed to show more school spirit, supposedly.
Dude, it's in the script. Extra. Extra announcements, people.
Let's go to extra announcements.
Hey, Tigers. My name's Dylan Castiglione. And this is Extra Announcements. Prom is coming up in a couple of weeks. Make sure to get your tickets soon. Prices are $90 with an ASB sticker and $100 without. Make sure to get them quick before prices go up. Make sure to come to room 607 on Wednesday mornings to pick up $1 hot chocolate and $1 coffee. Make sure to leave a tip because they're doing a great job. Next week is Teacher Appreciation Week. Make sure to bring some gifts to appreciate your teachers. I want to give a big 18th birthday shout out to our producer and scriptwriter, Ava Ochoa. Happy birthday, Ava. You're the prettiest girl in our group, minus Julian, of course.
That's all, folks.
No, no, it's not.
It's 95 with an ASB sticker? No, it's not. It's 90.
His laugh.
Average crazy. Appreciation Week is next week. Make sure to bring some gifts to appreciate your teachers.
Yeah, because you're touching your shirt.
Oh my God, bro.
That's all for this week's Tigers. I'm Jonathan Sosa.
And I'm Noah Smith. Have a great weekend, Tigers.
Raiden.
Hi, guys.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
welcome.
I missed that face.
I know. Me too.
Thank you.